Sahanavavatu Sahanaupunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavaditamastu Ma Vitvishavahai Om Shantihi Shantihi Shantihi.
Virabhadrasana and Uttita Parsva Konasana. Virabhadra, the name of a fierce warrior, an incarnation of Lord Shiva. Uttita means extended, Parsva means side, Kona is an angle. Benefits: strengthens your shoulders, arms, thighs, legs, and ankles, increases stamina and endurance, relieves cramp in the calf and thigh muscles, stimulates abdominal and pelvic organs and digestion, develops the chest and reduces fat around the waist and hips, relieves backaches, sciatic and arthritic pains, improves balance, concentration, and pinpoint focus. Virabhadrasana, advanced posture. This asana is an intensified continuation of Virabhadrasana 2. Benefits: helps to tone the abdominal organs and makes the leg muscles more shapely and sturdy. Strengthens ankles, arms, shoulders, and muscles of the back. Helps one to stand firmly on the soles of the feet and gives agility to the body and mind. Builds balance, concentration, and focus. Quiets the mind and the nervous system. Caution: please avoid this asana if you have an injury to the foot, ankle, knee, leg, hip, or have high blood pressure or cardiac condition. Parsvottanasana. Parsva means side or flank. Uttana means intense stretch. Benefits: relieves stiffness in the legs and hip muscles. Makes hip joints and spine elastic. Increases flexibility of the neck, shoulders, elbows, and wrists, and may help those with arthritis. Corrects round and drooping shoulders. The shoulders are well stretched, and this makes deep breathing easier. Cools the brain, soothes the nervous system, strengthens the abdominal organs, and improves digestion. Caution: please avoid this asana if you have an injury to the hips, back, or shoulders, or have high blood pressure or dysentery or a cardiac condition. Urdhva Dhanurasana. This backbending posture uses gravity to help you go into the posture. Benefits. This asana tones the spine by stretching it fully and keeps the body alert and supple. The back feels strong and full of life, strengthens the arms and wrists, and has a very soothing effect in the head. Caution. This posture is strictly for advanced level practitioners with a strong and flexible back. Not recommended for pregnant women, people suffering from cardiac conditions, or for those with a history of stroke, high or low blood pressure, or those with chronic back or hip problems. Natarajasana. Natta means dancer and Raja means king or lord. So this asana is also known as Lord of the Dance. This vigorous and beautiful posture is dedicated to Shiva, Lord of the Dance, who is also the source of yoga. Benefits. Stretches the shoulders and the chest. The shoulder blades get full movement, opens up the chest and the lungs, thus increasing the breathing capacity of the lungs. Stretches the thighs, groin, and abdomen. All the vertebral joints benefit from this asana. Strengthens the legs and ankle. Develops concentration and balance. Caution! Avoid this asana if you have high blood pressure or injury to the lower back or knee. Uttanasana. Ut means intense. Dhan means to stretch or extend. Uttana means intense stretch. Benefits. Stretches hamstring, calves, and hips. Strengthens the thighs and knees. This asana relieves stomach pains and tones the liver, the spleen, and the kidneys. It soothes the brain cells and helps relieve stress and mild depression. Reduces fatigue and anxiety. Upavistha Konasana. Upavistha means seated. Kona means angle. Upavistha Konasana is a good preparation for most of the seated forward bend and twisted postures. Benefits. Stretches the hamstrings and helps the blood circulate properly in the pelvic region and keeps it healthy. Stretches inner thigh muscles, lower back, and spine. Since the asana controls and regularizes the menstrual flow, this posture is very helpful to women. Relieves sciatic pains. Groin muscles are released. Calms the brain.